So what's going on, guys? It's JMSB Boxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click onto any of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions in what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So according to Dan Rayfield, the head writer for Boxing through SBN, he's saying that the Guillermo Rigondeaux victory over Moses Flores on the undercard of Andre Ward and Sergey Kovalev on Saturday night will be overturned to a no contest. Guillermo Rigondeaux retained his WBA super bantamweight title after knocking Flores out in one round, but the punch landed after the bell and Flores seemed hurt after the punch, and then he just slowly fell to the floor. And a lot of people were saying he made a meal out of it. In my opinion, he did make a bit of a meal out of it, but he said that he couldn't continue, and after much deliberation from the referee and the Nevada State Athletic Commission for about 10-15 minutes after the fight, the punch was deemed legal and Guillermo Rigondeaux won the fight by first round KO. But now they're saying that the decision will be overturned to a no contest, and in my opinion, you can't really blame it if it gets turned to a no contest. I know a lot of people are going to say, yeah, Flores threw a punch as well after the bell but missed, and Guillermo Rigondeaux's connected and that's why Flores got knocked out. But at the end of the day, the bell did ring, but the referee saying that Guillermo Rigondeaux was holding behind the neck of Moses Flores and throwing punches, that had nothing to do with the actual knockout itself. So that explanation by the referee at the time, in my opinion, was ridiculous, because when the punch was thrown, Guillermo Rigondeaux wasn't holding anyone by the neck or around the neck. So I don't know what the referee was saying then to the Nevada State Athletic Commission. I thought that was ridiculous. But Guillermo Rigondeaux can't catch a break, can he? Like, this guy finds it so hard to get fights. That's why he's been so inactive. I think he's had about, what, 3 rounds of boxing in about 2 years. Like, the guy's boxed about 3 rounds in 2 years, and it is sad to see, because this guy is a great talent. And even though his fight with Flores only lasted a round, you could see that Guillermo Rigondeaux was a special talent. Like, he was standing right in front of Moses Flores, a bigger man than him, a lot taller, with a longer reach, and he just couldn't land anything on Guillermo Rigondeaux at all. And he was just slipping the shots all through the round, and then he hit that big shot that knocked Flores out, but it was just unfortunate that it was after the bell. So you can't really complain if it gets ruled a no contest, and if it does, I think Guillermo Rigondeaux should have a rematch with Moses Flores, because Moses Flores is his mandatory challenger, or was his mandatory challenger. So if it's ruled a no contest, I think Guillermo Rigondeaux should try and get a rematch with him, and then try and get a clear victory against Flores. Because in my opinion, I was thinking, yeah, this is going to be an easy night for Guillermo Rigondeaux. He looked the better fighter. He was landing single shots and just slipping Moses Flores, and it just seemed like Guillermo Rigondeaux was just getting into his stride even early as the first round. So I think he should give Flores the rematch if it's ruled as a no contest, and then he can try and put all the controversy to bed. But this guy just can't catch a break at the end of the day. He finds it so hard to get fights and to get put on networks and stuff like that, especially on HBO. But at the end of the day, it is what it is, and sometimes this shit happens in boxing and you just gotta get on with it. But yeah, Guillermo Rigondeaux's first round knockout of Moses Flores looks like it's going to be turned to a no contest. So yeah, comment below in the comment section, what's your guys' opinions of this? Do you think it's fair? Do you think Rigondeaux is being hard done by? Do you think it should have been harsher on Guillermo Rigondeaux? Do you think he should have been disqualified and actually lost the fight? So yeah, just comment below in the comment section.